cars outside. I got hoes trying to ride up. Even when I'm fucked up, everything I'm about, shout it out in front of. I ain't trying to hide nothing. Every day I do is live. I am busting the pages. I need a face. Driving my space. Get out my space. Get out my face.
Thank you. Hey! Hey!
So I just wanted to briefly touch on something that I think is really important to me, and I think it's really important to a young man's progression or a young female's progression in life, and that's finding something that challenges yourself and challenges you to be better every single day in life. In particular for me, that was lifting and going to the gym. So I started going to the gym 3 years ago, and my main reason for going was because I just wanted something to do. Honestly, I didn't really have some, you know, deep backstory. I was a very skinny kid. I was going through a bit of body image issues, but I never really got to a point where that was the reason why I got in the gym. I think I genuinely was just bored, and I lived down the road from a gym, so I would just drive there every night at midnight and just get a lift in, and eventually I fell in love with it. I just wanted to briefly touch on how lifting really changed my life and how I think it's a really vital part to a young person's development. And if you're a young person that's really struggling to find their place in this world or feeling lost and lonely, just try lifting, man. I feel like if you just go to the gym and you try it for 3 months, 6 months, even a month, just watch how your life changes. I think the one thing with the gym which is so amazing is that you don't really realize, but it makes you so much more disciplined in every other aspect of life, including your family, your hobbies, your work, your relationships, and everything else. I feel like the discipline you get in the gym really translates to every other aspect of your life, and that's a really underrated part of going to the gym. I know I was really struggling coming out of high school when I was 18 years old. I was very lost, and I didn't really know what I was doing, what my purpose was. I wasn't really helping out around the house. I wasn't really helping anyone around me. And I was kind of trying to figure out why I'm here, why I'm on the earth, like what my purpose is here. Which now I believe my purpose is to inspire and motivate people. And that sounds cringe, but the amount of people that I have touched through my journey and through my social media with fitness and stuff, it's kind of given me that realization that this is a way I can help people. Not everyone's going to be into it. A lot of people are going to judge for it. A lot of people are going to think that it's a piss take or think it's a joke, and think, oh, influencing social media, all this and that, it's a bit cringe, you know. But the thing is, I've had a lot of people message me saying that my kind of content, my mindset, the things I've posted about my own issues and struggles has really helped other people with their life and made them not feel so alone. And that's a really beautiful thing. And I'm really privileged to be in that position where my story can do that for people. But back to the point that I was trying to make is that if you're really struggling to find your purpose in life and you feel lost, you feel confused, you're not sure why you're here on this earth, I'm just saying, go to the gym, give it a try. If you hate it, you don't ever have to do it again. But just give it a try and just see how much your life changes in 3 to 6 months. And beyond that, as you progress the years through the gym. I remember being 18, running in my first few times from the gym and telling my mom how excited I was about this certain weight I lifted, or, you know, I benched this, or I look at this new vein that popped up in my arm, and she was probably just like, cool, couldn't really fathom what that meant, but to me it was really special, and I think she was just happy because I was excited about something. I had something that I was really passionate about to improve every single day, and I wanted to keep getting better. In this really big aspect of my life, which a lot of 18-year-olds don't really have something in their life that they want to progress every single day in, and they want to be better and better, and it therefore improves every other aspect of their life. Like, I was eating good, I was cooking meals in the kitchen, I was, you know, disciplined in the gym with my health, I wasn't drinking a lot of alcohol, I wasn't going out and doing drugs and partying. Obviously, you enjoy yourself to a certain extent being a young person, and I did have a good balance there, but I prioritize my health, and years down the line, I've now turned this into something that I can prioritize as a career, I can prioritize into the future, and I can make something out of it. Now I have about 4 or 5 business ventures that I'm planning to do and complete in the next year or two, and I'm thinking about getting properties down the line. I'm thinking about, you know, all this adult stuff that I had never ever thought about before, and this all stems from lifting, because I found something I was passionate about. I found a way to turn that into a career, and I found a way to kind of revolve my life around it. And the big issue with lifting is a lot of people look at it and go, oh, there's more to life than the gym. You know, there's more to life than just how you look and, you know, getting to the gym every day and your muscles and being shredded. It's like, yes, I agree. There is so much more to life than that. But when it's something that brings you so much enjoyment and it's something that you want to be better at every single day, why is that such an issue? You know, like, why do people get so caught up on this? You know, the world doesn't revolve around the gym. You know, have a life, you know, get a life outside the gym. It's like, why? Why can't the gym be the biggest part of my life? You know, like, it brings me happiness, brings me discipline, brings me motivation. It gets rid of a lot of negative mental and physical emotions that I feel. And then I leave the gym a happier person and I leave the gym a better person. I just think it's a funny thing, the stigma around it. And it's just something I wanted to briefly touch on, because if I'm going to have a platform like this where people are going to watch my videos, and if I'm going to have a platform and be a creator, you know, I want to use it for good. You know, that's why I speak on mental health. That's why I speak on my struggles with anxiety, depression, dissociation. I speak on my struggles with autoimmune diseases, relationships, which is something I want to touch on more, the effects that going through relationships can have on your life, and feeling lonely, feeling torn, feeling betrayed, all these different things that I've experienced and a lot of other people have experienced around my age and even older. And I think having a platform is great and all, but it's only so good if you're going to use it for good and you're going to use it to try to change the world, change people's perspectives, is actually influencing people, and hopefully you're influencing people for the better. Anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed the video. I'm going to try to get these out twice a week. I've been slacking on YouTube a lot just because I've really been honing on my Instagram and trying to grow that a lot, which has been amazing. Just this year alone, I think we've gone from about 7 or 8K to 44,000, which we hit today, which is incredible. I don't even know what to say. The fact that many people are, you know, want to see my content, and the engagement is so high, which is amazing. It's a really heartwarming thing, and it's something I dreamed of having years ago. And the fact that I do have that now is incredible. I think there's a big gap in the Australian bodybuilding scene for creators who are just raw, honest, into bodybuilding, but not the kind of social media world around it. Because there's a lot of creators that I know and a lot of creators I see which create amazing content, but it's very planned out. It's very structured. It's humor videos. It's viral videos, that kind of thing. And I guess I look at the big creators in America, like Lex Little, Gabe Douche, I think that's how you say his name, you know, James English, you know, even David Lade's original videos. They're all these guys who just film their life, and they film them lifting, they film their progression, both as a lifter and as a person. And I think that's a really cool thing. I think there's a big gap in Australia for that kind of thing. I definitely want to fill that space, and I feel like I can. I have a lot of confidence in myself in this current moment of time to really do something with this platform. And I appreciate everyone that's watching this video. I appreciate everyone that's stuck with me through kind of my journey the last 6 months. But yeah, other than that, like I said, thank you for watching the video. I love every single one of you, and I hope you guys are really doing something amazing with your life. I hope you're trying to make a change if things are going negative. If you've taken anything from this video, it's that lifting can bring you a lot of joy. And yeah, I don't know, there's a great community around lifting, and I hope you guys can kind of get in touch with that if you're struggling to find your place in this world. I love you guys. Thank you for watching. Two videos a week now. I'm going to try every Tuesday and Saturday. Fingers crossed I can do it, but I'm going to give it my best shot. Thank you for watching, and I hope you guys have an amazing week.